My name is Dr. Tanya Simuni. I am Chief of Movement Disorders and Professor of Neurology at Northwestern Medicine. Parkinson's is a lifelong condition. It is a slowly progressive condition. Obviously, when someone has the age of onset in their 40s and 50s, they have a long lifespan ahead of them. And they have different objectives for the management of the disease today and for the future. Today, they're dealing with the social impact of the disease, in their career still at the peak of its development, in their family management. For tomorrow, it is slowing progression of the major milestones of disability. So the focus is on wellness, early introduction of exercise as part of the medical management of the disease, coping strategies with the disease, in the realm of pharmacological management, choosing the therapeutics that will provide them effective therapy today and reduce the risk of development of complications of therapy like dyskinesia, motor fluctuations. Levodopa is the prodrug of dopamine, the chemical that the brain of people with Parkinson's are deficient on. That is the oldest therapeutic that was developed in the late 60s. There have been multiple classes of agents developed since then. And while 10 years ago we tried to shy away from levodopa because of the higher risk of motor complications, dyskinesia, fluctuations, we now recognize that it's still the most potent therapy and remains the mainstream of therapeutic approach. The focus of our research portfolio is development of therapeutics to slow and ultimately halt and reverse progression of the disease. As of today, Parkinson's field is fortunate to have quite effective therapies to treat motor signs of the disease disability. We don't have a single drug or therapeutic intervention to slow progression of the disease. The field is more active than ever with a large number of experimental therapeutics being tested specifically with a focus of slowing progression of the disease. And we are one of the few centers, probably national and internationally, that is participating in really the most exciting therapeutic, experimental therapeutics programs. I believe that the field is most excited about the personalized approaches to therapeutics in Parkinson's, similar to the other diseases. And in Parkinson's, the focus is on genetically targeted therapeutics. And there are a couple of genetic mutations at variants that are associated with increased risk of Parkinson's disease, specifically LARC mutation carriers, GBA mutation carriers, and for the first time ever in the history of drug development in Parkinson's, those therapeutics are in the clinical stage of development. I am very optimistic based on our current understanding of the biology of the disease, based on the highly qualified programs going into the clinic, that we will start seeing transformative therapies. Any professional who is interacting with a person specifically with a newly diagnosed Parkinson's disease, specifically with a young onset Parkinson's disease, ideally should introduce the concept of experimental therapies as part of the diagnosis counseling and establish the contact with the centers around the country that are involved with those therapeutic programs that have access to the cutting-edge experimental therapies. And similarly, genetic testing for Parkinson's disease. Only partnership will lead us to success.